Hello friends, welcome to KB Tutorials. In this tutorial, we are going to see how can we switch among the browser windows in Selenium WebDriver. I have a classical example here. I am at Kotak web page where I want to log into my net banking. So I came into this home page. Once I click on it, I came into the main page. And in this main page, I need to enter 123. Okay. So this is my scenario. So what we are going to do is, I'll click on this login. This will be the new window. So we'll learn how we can switch to the new window in Selenium WebDriver, and we'll learn how we can switch back to the main window, and we'll do some actions here. Okay, so this is very, very interesting concept, guys. I want you all to practice this, and this particular scenario is really interesting. So I created particular class here called switching among windows, where I have set my Chrome driver path and I have set up the Chrome driver, and I'm navigating to this particular web page and I'm trying to maximize. Okay, now let me try to run this and show you how the output is coming. So yeah, one second. Before running, I just want to show you the current window. Okay, handle. So how we can get the current window handle? So current window handle, how we can get that? So string, let me keep something like handle as a variable using wd, that is a web driver dot get window handle will return the this. Okay, so will return the window handle, then current window will be current window handle is c handle. Okay, let me try to execute this and show you what is the current window act of this particular web page. Now you can see it started running. It's loading the Kotak website, which we are going to automate. Then it tried to maximize this. After that, now you can see this is my current window handle. Okay. Then if I click on the login page, not login page, sorry, login button. So let me try to find out the login button. It is at span having the test of login. So I'll try to create a customized expat for this. Text is equal to login. Then if I click on this, so wd.findElementByXPath of this. Click on this. Okay, once I click on this, what happens? It will enter a new window. So the control is at this particular field, is input box. Okay, this particular field. So let me try to get the window of this first of all. Okay, and see what we can do. So once I click on this, what I can do is, let me try to get the window handle of that. Okay, so after clicking window handle, that will be like wd.get window handle, and try to execute this. Now you can see I started executing. It is loading the Kotak web page. Then it will click on the login button. Now you can see it clicked on the login button, and the control came here. Okay, this input field, CRN input field, control came here. But if you see, if you observe properly, even though control came to the next page, but as per the Selenium, the script is in the first page. How do I am saying that is based on the window handle. Both are the same. So the script is in the first page only. So if I do something here in the second page, it is going to get failed, because as of now, the script, as per the script, this control is in this page only. Okay. So to just to show that, okay, I'll try to click on this no more. Is it anchor tag having the text? No more. Okay. Now I'll try to click on this and it should work to me, because I'm in the first page only. So let's see. Find element by XPath. This one dot. I won't get no such element exception. Maybe displayed or not. Might we'll get. Let's see that. Now it started running. As you can see, it started running. Maximized, clicked. Control is here. Now you can see something is clicked on it. This, okay. Something has happened. So the script is failed. No, script is not failed, because even though control is this, actually as per the script, the control is here based on the window handle. So I clicked on that. Okay. So how do I get the list of window handles so that I can move into the next page? I'll enter something there. So to do that, use w.getWindowHandles. This is returning set. So let me use set here, set string. Let me use handles. Then to loop through the set, I'll use iterator it is equal to handles dot iterator. Okay. Then try to import your iterator from the java.utils package. Okay. And how do I loop through this iterator? Using the while loop. Okay. While loop like it dot has next. Okay. Then what I'll do is I'll create one string called handle. So let me keep it as null. Here what I'll do is I'll try to get the window handle for each and everything using this while loop. Okay. It dot next dot toString. So I got this window. So what I can do is simply, what happened? Simply I'll try to print on this, and I'll come to know how many windows are there. Based on the window handle, I'll come to know how many windows are there. I'm printing those window handles. Okay. So started running now. So it goes to the Kotak web page. It will try to maximize there. Clicks on the login. And here, if you see how many are there, here if you see, I have two window handles. Okay. The first one is this one, which I am already there. I am already having in another variable. And the second one is this one, new one. Okay. So the first handle, I already have it in the variable. What is that variable? This is a variable, C handle. So using if else, I'll identify the second handle. Simply using if else. So I already having it in C handle, right? So C handle dot, I'll use equals, content equals of equals, anything is fine, equals of handle. So both are matching. That means I don't need, but I need the second one that will only come in the else. Okay. So what I'll do here is I'll just create one more string called new handle. I'll assign null value, then new handle is equal to handle. So first one I have two, the first one is already there in C handle, so if will get executed, else won't get executed, then it will again come to while, and it is already having one more. So it dot height has next will be true, comes here, and C handle is not is equal to handle this time, so it comes to the else, and I am assigning the value in the new handle. Okay, so once I have it in there, what I can do is using this new handle I can switch to the new window, right? So how can I do that? Using wd dot switch to dot window. Now you can see handle name, it is asking for handle name, that is there in new handle, right? Now I am switching here. Now once I switch here, I want to enter something in this CRN input field, but if I want to inspect using right click, it is not working. Right click is disabled in this application, being a banking application they have secured. So I'll use Control Shift I to get the inspect, and here what I'll just do one, I'll just close this, I'll apply Control Shift I again. If you see here, it's there is something called frame set, that means there were little bit of frames are there. So if you just mouse over on this, there is nothing, but if you mouse over on this particular frame, everything in this frame. So I need to get this particular frame, and I'll be switching into that particular frame. So switch to dot frame, and based on the frame name, this is my frame name. Okay, then after that I'll try to identify this particular element having the ID as username. Simply use find elements by ID dot username, and I'm sending the keys as 123. Okay, if you do manually, if you try to send any alphabetical value, it is not taking, but if you send numerical value, is taking. Okay, so that's why I'm sending 123 here. And let me try to execute and see whether it is working fine or not. Now you can see it started working. So it is loaded the browser, and it will try to maximize here. So it should maximize now. Click on the login. In the login, I should enter 123 in input text field. So I'm waiting for that. Now you can see it entered 123. Okay, so it executed successfully. Now what I want to do is I want to switch back to this particular frame, and I want to switch back to this particular window here. Okay, how can I do? Simply use wd dot switch to dot window of handle. It is asking for handle, the first one. The first one will be C handle, that I already have it in my variable. Okay, so let's me run this and show you whether the control is moving into the previous page or not. Okay, now you can see I started running this. It is loading the Kotak web page, and it will try to maximize here. Maximize, click on the login, and it will enter something here. So 123 something it is entered. After that it should go back to the previous page. Okay, that we are going to see. Now you can see it entered something and it came back to this previous page. Okay, this it entered, it came back to this particular page. This is how we can do window handling switching among the windows in a browser using Selenium WebDriver. I hope it's informative for you guys. Thank you so much for